After 4 long videos, we have finally completed making a circuit using the schematic editor. And this looks amazing, and we are very close in making our own printed circuit board. All we have to do is do some electrical rule check to the circuit and assign some footprints. It's always good to double check, because there is usually a high possibility that we make some sort of mistake. So KiCad offers some basic checklist that would help us build a very robust circuit with very minimal error. You can see this checklist on the schematic setup. Now go to the toolbar and click on the schematic setup. Now under this, click on the electrical rules. And here you can see all the rules that KiCad has previously set up for us. For example, pin not connected, a pin with a no connection flag, and we have duplicate reference designators, and symbol is not annotated, and many more. This takes care of a lot of tiny details that we easily miss out on. I suggest not changing any of these settings unless you know what you're doing with it. Now let's see how to perform electrical rule check and see if our circuit passes all those rules. Go to the toolbar again and click on perform electrical rule check. And then click on run ERC. Here you can see we have one warning and two error. And you can use this checkbox to select what you want to see and what you want to ignore. In our case, first let's start with fixing the errors and later focus on the warning. So I'll just uncheck the warnings. Let's start with one error at a time. The first one, pin not connected. So in the previous video, I mentioned we need to place no connection flag on the pins that are not used. This is to tell KiCad that we are willingly giving up the pin, and it's not an accident that we missed connecting those pins. So I'll click on add no connection flag and then add the flag to the pin. Now let's run the ERC again. And you can see the number of errors reduced to 2. And these 2 errors would be the most often errors that you can face on KiCad before moving on to the PCB editor. This basically means KiCad doesn't know which net carries the power and not sure how the components are powered. So this can be easily fixed. All you have to do is go to add power symbol and search for power flag. And now we just add this to VCC and ground. Once that's done, we'll run the ERC again. And you can see we have solved all the errors. Now we'll look at the warnings and see how to fix that. So the switch S1 has one unplaced unit. So what does this mean? To better understand, we'll try to add the same symbol again. So I'll go to add symbol. And we'll search for the switch. You can see the switch contains 2 units, unit A and unit B. This is KiCad trying to simplify the double pole double throw switch into 2 single pole double throw switches, which is technically correct. And the circuit we have built still holds good. We can also go ahead with the warning and go to PCB development. Because this is just a symbol that represents the switch, it doesn't have any physical dimension or shape of the switch assigned to it. But I would prefer to fix the warning before we move further. So let's search for single pole double throw switch and replace it with the existing switch. Now when you try to do the electrical rules check, you can see the schematic is not annotated. So if you make any changes, make sure you annotate before you do the ERC again. So let me do the annotation. Then let's click on ERC and let's run the ERC again. And you can see we have 0 violation and the circuit is perfect. There are a lot more errors and warnings that you can face while using ERC. But covering each one of them wouldn't be possible. But most of the errors are readable and self-explanatory. If you need any help, you can always reach out to us at PCBCupid Q&A. So far, we have completed the schematic. This is perfect to share and showcase your circuit. But most of the components here on the circuits are generic. For example, we use the resistor R and its value. But we are unaware of the type of the resistor, either it's SMD or a through-wall component. and also we are not sure what is the wattage of the resistor. And for few of the other components, we might have a different branch which might have same functionality but totally different physical dimension and its appearance. To fix this, we have the footprint assignment tool in KiCad. This assigns each symbol with its physical counterpart called footprint. I think you get the idea why it's called footprint, because we considered the 2D cross section of the component and how it's placed. For analogy, we can consider a human footprint. Just by seeing the footprint, we can figure out how the person was standing and in some cases, what he was trying to do. Similarly, we can use the component's footprint to determine the orientation and the placement of the component. Since we nailed down the basics, let's see how we can do this in KiCad. You can open the footprint editor on the toolbar. You can see some of the components are assigned by KiCad and some of the unassigned components are highlighted in yellow. It's not possible to have all the components in the world within a single software. But KiCad does have a huge collection of footprints. In later videos, we'll discuss how we can make our custom symbol with a custom footprint. First, let me quickly walk you over this footprint assignment window. If you look at the left, we have all the component names, example, resistor, capacitor, diode, and LED. And now see on the right, we have the actual footprint for each of the component. To view the component, select the footprint and do a right click and click on View Selected Footprint. This will take us to a window which shows us the 2D cross section which I was talking earlier. Now if you want to know how this looks in 3D, you can either use this icon or press Alt+3 to see the 3D view of the component. In upcoming videos, we'll discuss more about this 3D viewer, also we'll discuss more about this footprint editor. For now, let's go back to the footprint assignment tool. There are few key points that we need to consider before placing the footprint. Can we source the component? Just because the footprint is available on KiCad, that doesn't mean we can get the physical component easily. Make sure to do the research for the parts and see if it's easier to source. Importantly, make sure it is available after a few months, also after a few years. Imagine if the design and the components aren't chosen properly, the PCB will become obsolete very soon and we might have to redesign the whole thing again. Is the component cost effective? Always check if the components are cost effective. The whole reason to build a PCB is to keep the cost down during production while doing higher quantities. So even a small difference for one PCB can make a huge difference while mass manufacturing. Cross-check with the datasheet of the component. Each component will have a datasheet and its footprint and its physical dimension. Just double-check if your footprint is matching the dimensions. If you're just getting started, I highly recommend getting the components on hand and then assign the footprints. Don't do guesswork or don't rely on datasheet, because some of the vendors may provide a totally different datasheet and supply completely a different part. It takes time and experience to find a reliable vendor who can ship the promised product at low cost with fast delivery. Can machines assemble it? We can sometimes choose the low cost component or a part that works for the circuit, but it might come with a caveat of us assembling it manually. It should be totally fine if you are doing a few PCB or planning to do a smaller quantity, but this would increase the cost drastically during large production because manual labor is way more expensive than machines. These are just a few points and there's a lot more to consider as you scale up. In the next video, we'll continue further and finish assigning the footprints. And later we'll see how to take the entire circuit inside the PCB editor and start building the PCB. So until then, if you have any questions or doubts, you can always reach out to me at PCBCupid Q&A. And make sure to like the video and share it with people who might be interested in this kind of content. And also don't forget to subscribe. Until then, keep learning and keep creating.